for your invitation and your hospitality. Also, a special thanks to Mr. Albino Pineda for initiating this worthwhile recognition to nuestra gente. Quisiera darles las gracias al Comité de Santa Paula, al Monumento de los Campesinos y a todos ustedes. También al Dr. Gavino Aguirre por su invitación y su hospitalidad. Y también al señor Albino Pineda por soñar esta idea y ayudar a hacerla realidad. Today, Sunday, August 15, 2010, marks a historic moment for Santa Paula, for each and one of you, and also as a former farm worker, para mí también. As I understand, this is the very first monument dedicated to the contributions of farm workers. Este es el primer monumento en este país dedicado a las contribuciones a los campesinos. We are very proud that Santa Paula is making history in being the first. Estamos muy orgullosos que Santa Paula está creando la historia en ser el primero en reconocer el campesino. Así que los felicito muchos a ustedes. However, I certainly hope to be attending many more of these types of events throughout the country, as all of America needs to be aware of nuestras gentes' efforts in ensuring that food is readily available at every American dinner table. We are thankful for heroes like Cesar Chavez and Dolores Huerta. Their efforts in the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s allowed farm workers to improve their work conditions and earnings. Estamos muy orgullosos de nuestros héroes, César Chávez y Dolores Huerta, que con sus esfuerzos en los años 60, 70, 80 y 90, pudieron pelear para mejores condiciones y mejor salario a los campesinos. Así que hay que reconocer a los pioneros de los derechos de los campesinos. And even though efforts in 1986 led to thousands of farm workers to receive amnesty in the 1986 Federal Immigration Act, this country still has over 12 million undocumented workers in today. So we have a lot of more work ahead of us. We've come too far to quit now. This is the time we should stand tall and fight for greater things in our community. Many people ask how in the world I, as a former farm worker, was able to become an astronaut and travel to the stars. Well, I remember my experiences as a farm worker very well. As a kid, as a family of four, the youngest of the family of four, viajábamos de Michoacán a California cada año. The routine, la rutina, was all too common de nuestra gente de Michoacán. My dad would pack the car up in Michoacán. We would make the two-day trip. Un viaje de dos días en carro. Llegábamos aquí a Ontario, California. Iniciábamos con la cosecha de la fresa. We started with the strawberry season. Luego nos movíamos a Salinas, donde trabajábamos en la lechuga, en el asadón. Y el mayor parte de nuestro tiempo, the biggest chunk of our time, was spent in Northern California, in Stockton, Modesto, Tracy. Allí es donde trabajamos en las cosechas del pepino, de la cereza, del jitomate verde, de la uva, en fin, todo lo que crecía y necesitaba piscar. Ahí estábamos con nuestros paisanos de Michoacán y de todo México, todos los latinos. So, as I was saying, the routine was very simple. My dad would pack the kids up in Michoacán for the two-day trip in February, and we would start in Ontario, where we start strawberry picking, made our way up to Salinas, where we worked in the lettuce and working in the hoe, and then the bulk of our time was spent up in Stockton, Modesto, Tracy, where we worked in cherries, cucumbers, grapes, green tomatoes, whatever was grown in the area, we would pick him along with our fellow Michoacanos. And se llegaba noviembre, November would roll around, and hacíamos lo que hacíamos todos los migrantes. My dad would pack up the kids and my mom, y hacíamos what would now be a 2.5-day trip. 2 días y medio ya nos regresábamos a Michoacán, a la Piedad Michoacán, donde somos. Arriba, arriba los reboceros, ¿verdad? And so the routine would repeat itself in February. We would do the same thing over and over. I think what distinguished my parents, lo que separó a mis padres a otros campesinos, era que apreciaban la educación. They appreciated the education. And in spite of their third grade education, ellos no terminaron la tercer grado de primaria. Wherever we were, siempre asegurábamos que estábamos inscribidos en la escuela. De lunes a viernes, en la escuela. Eso sí, se llegaba el sábado y domingo y a fregarle con los demás en el campo, en la pizca. My parents would always put us in school Monday through Friday. But weekends rolled around, we were out there in the fields working with them. And mucha gente, a mis compañeros les gustaba las vacaciones de verano. We hated them, of course. We hated summer vacations because that signified we would be working in the field 7 days a week. And entonces that was the routine. That was the routine. And what was also different for my parents is the fact that as kids grow older, in a migrant farm working family, you typically pull the kids out of school so they can work in the fields because now they would earn close to what an adult can make. And I remember my parents being ridiculed by uncles, by friends, because we would stay in school y le hacían la burla. It says, you're giving up 4 paychecks. You're being a fool. Why are you having them in school? You need to put them in the fields. Y entonces es la ignorancia de nuestra gente que nosotros tenemos que salir de ese ciclo vicioso de sentenciar a nuestros hijos a los campos, sino que hay que darles la oportunidad, ya que nosotros no tuvimos, ustedes no tuvieron, hay que darles la oportunidad de que sigan sus estudios para que ellos también puedan realizar sus sueños. Yo recuerdo, I remember the very first time I wanted to be an astronaut. Y le doy yo las gracias a ser un campesino en que naciera este sueño. Porque como ustedes saben, cuando uno trabaja en el campo, uno se levanta en la madrugada, ¿verdad? You get up early in the morning. It's still dark out there. The stars are still out. And if you're real early, like my dad was, nos íbamos al campo en lo oscuro y esperábamos ahí en el campo hasta que saliera el sol para empezar la pizca del pepino o lo que sea. So we would go to the fields when it was still dark, wait till the sun came out and the first daybreak, we would start working in the fields, like picking cucumbers. And I remember, I used to get out of the car in the fields. I would always get out because there was no light pollution. Estaba bien oscuro. And I would look up in the sky and I would see the stars so clear. And I would say, man, they look beautiful. I hope one day I would get the opportunity to travel up there. And that's when the dream started percolating. And then, And then what happened was, of course, unfortunately, I have to admit, I'm old enough to remember the tail end of the Apollo program. And if you guys remember that, those who are old enough will remember that whenever we had a moonwalk and Apollo landed on the moon, they would preempt programming and we would watch TV. Everybody would see the moonwalk. The whole world would watch it, and our family was no different. Only difference is we didn't have a color TV. We had the old consola type of TVs con las bocinas integrales, las cuatro patitas, parecía un mueble, ¿no? It was a big piece of furniture. And ours was black and white, snowy picture. Y de vez en cuando you would lose that horizontal sink y le tenías que dar un golpe para que se arreglara, ¿verdad? That was our TV. And God forbid that, okay, at that time, satellite TV no existía televisión satélite, pero sí existía el cable, but we didn't have enough money for cable. So the next best thing we had was, we used esas orejas de conejo antenas que se ponen arriba de la televisión. Esa es la que utilizábamos nosotros. Y yo, being the budding engineer that I was, cuando íbamos al campo, mi mamá hacía los tacos y los envolvía en papel de aluminio, ¿verdad? Entonces yo hacía extensiones muy grandes de las antenas para agarrar mejor recepción. Entonces es cuando yo creo que supe que iba a ser ingeniero. That's when I knew I was going to be an engineer. My mom used to wrap up our tacos when we go to the fields and work in aluminum foil. I used to save the aluminum foil and use them as extensions to our rabbit ear antennas. And that's when I knew I was going to be a budding engineer. But I remember I used to complain to my parents a lot, my dad specifically. Me quejaba con ellos porque nosotros teníamos siempre lo peor de peor, ¿verdad? Televisión viejita. Y al cambiarle tenía the big knob. Y entonces yo al cambiarle una vez le decía a mi papá, dice, ay papás, ¿qué no sabes que ya hay televisiones de color y con control remoto? Y entonces me queda viendo y dice, ay muchacho, dices, ¿para qué necesito control remoto si te tengo a ti? Cámbiale. Says, why do I need a remote control if I have you? Go change it. And then he says, ¿y quieres color? Utiliza tu imaginación. Use your imagination, you want color. So he always had a practical answer for everything. And so I remember when we had to see something very important on TV, of course the antenna would not be in good reception. And of course yours truly was the official, aside from being the official channel changer, I was also the adjuster for the antenna. Y uno sabe qué es lo que pasa cuando uno inmediatamente tienta la antena, ¿verdad? Cuando salían los astronautas caminando, querían ver la imagen más claro que podían. They wanted to see the best image, so they would ask me to come up and adjust the antenna. Well, as soon as I grabbed it, agarraba tierra. It would grab ground. I know this because I'm an electrical engineer now. So agarraba tierra, and instantaneously the image would improve, right? So guess what my dad would tell me? Ay, quédate. Entonces yo en forma contorsionista, queriendo ver las imágenes de los astronautas caminando en la luna, pero me dejaban allí diciendo, ay, quédate. Ahora, now that I became an astronaut, le hago la burla a mis hermanos mayores, porque yo siempre ajustaba la televisión. Les dije, ya ven, it was through osmosis, por osmosis. Me hice astronauta because the signals came through my body as I was holding that damn antenna. Yeah. Pero lo que sí recuerdo es as soon as the family had their fill of watching the images of the astronauts walking on the moon, ya cuando se llenaban ellos, ya me dejaban soltar la antena. And entonces yo me sentaba como estos niños aquí enfrente de la televisión viendo. Y veía unos 10, 15 minutos y luego corría afuera porque era oscuro y veía la luna llena. Corría para adentro y veía otra vez los astronautas caminando en la luna y otra vez lo hacía varias veces. Y yo creo que ahí es cuando oficialmente nació el sueño para mí de querer ser astronauta. Yo dije, tenía 9 años en ese tiempo, yo dije, that's what I want to do, I want to be an astronaut. I want to be an astronaut. And I remember que compartí este sueño con mis papás, ¿verdad? Especially mi mamá. Y muchas veces los padres nos dicen las verdades, pero a pesar, como yo les digo, que mis papás nomás tuvieron una educación de tercer grado de primaria, yo creo habían sido buenos psicólogos si hubieran estudiado, porque ellos, en vez de, cuando al compartir ese sueño,